how the draft rules have to be made in the new ordinance. The most important clause of this ordinance is of the provided further that in case of a housing society having less than or up to 200 members, the elections of the committee shall be conducted by the said housing society in a manner as may be prescribed. The way word prescribed comes means prescribed means rules. So that means there will be going to be rules to make how the elections of a cooperative housing society less than 200 members. Now it is expected that it may be made to 300 or 400 members, which means more than 95% of cooperative housing society elections will be conducted by the society themselves. Originally it was decided for 100, but when it went to the cabinet it became 200, and now when it has gone to the assembly they are talking about 400 members. Maybe a possibility, I'm just not ruling out the possibility, the possibility is that all cooperative housing societies, irrespective of the number of members, it may be made to get the election done by the society themselves. The moment we talk about the society themselves, is it a good idea? What should be the rules? There are divided opinions among the drafting committee. There are divided, you know, opinion among the various people. Now let us understand what are the two views which has been expressed. The one view that has been expressed is housing society managing committee will appoint a person from their own society or anybody else. The society will conduct the election. They will prepare the voting rights, voting rights, schedules of the programs, as well as the members list. Everything will be done by the society themselves and the officer appointed by them. The fees may be them. Like earlier in the bylaws it was there, the general body or the managing committee will appoint a retaining officer. The election will be conducted by the society themselves, or it may be done in the general body. So this is one view which has been promoted or said by n number of federations, n number of, you know, the people who are in the helm of the affairs. So the second which has come is that, okay, if at all it has to be done by cooperative society, but there has to be some control on this election. How this election control can be envisaged, how it can be done. The second option given by the various segment is let there be a panel of election officers, but this election officer will be under the control of the state election authority, Maharashtra State Cooperative Election Authority. They will maintain a panel the way there is a panel of auditors. With the qualification, Government of Maharashtra maintains the panel of auditors. Let there be a panel of election officers. These election officers will be recruited, appointed, or enrolled, empaneled by the Maharashtra State Cooperative Election Authority. They will work according to the directions of the Maharashtra State Cooperative Election Authority. They will also be appointed. Once they are appointed, it becomes their duty that the society will appoint the election officer only from this empanel election officers in their general body. Thereafter, within 15 days, that election officer as well as the society will intimate the appointment of the election officer to the state corporate election authority by email or on the web, what is known as website. There is a something called mandate written, and thereafter the election officer will prepare the voter list. There will be display of the voter list. Election officer only will finalize the voter list, and thereafter he will put 35 days election program, inviting the candidates, rejecting the candidates, and then, you know, scrutiny of the elections, the nomination forms, then finalizing the voter this candidates list, and then conduct the election through the ballot or otherwise. So this is what is, and thereafter once the election is done, that election officer will intimate the elected bodies to the registrar, who will constitute the committee, and thereafter it will be reported also to the election authority as to the conduct of the elections. Of course, anybody who is aggrieved, they can go to the cooperative court as it is now also, and 3 months that ballot paper and all other things will be maintained by the society. And after 3 months, because that is the 3 months which is given for challenging the election, if the challenging of the election does not take place, thereafter that can be, you know, dismantled, or this can be destroyed. But till the challenging period is available, the law of limitation is there, till such time this will be in the custody of the chairman. So this way the election will be done by the society, But through an officer who is empaneled with the state cooperative election authority. And now the question raised by many of the, you know, people who are in the helm of the affairs, who are now the chairman, secretaries or the committees of the society, is that what difference? Earlier state cooperative election is to appoint, now we will be appointing. Other than that, what is the big difference? So which means the red tapism, other things will continue. What is the issue? Let us address the issue. The issue is, one, in the current system, going to the election authority, asking them to appoint an election officer, taking its own time, which takes 3 to 6 months sometime, and maybe more than 1 year. And second, most important is the payment of the fees officially, one, because there is an official payment also involved, which is ranging from 4,000 to 10,000 rupees, depending on the number of members. The third and most important is, in order to make it very quick, or the authorities also expect, sometime the people who are on the helm of the affairs expect certain gratification, and that gratification, the quantity is not known, which we can call it as a speed money, we can call it as a corrupt practice, we can call whatever the name it is. So all this is happening. Now can we address all this? In order to address this, he is suggesting two things, which I understand. One, address all these three things. To address all these things, they have made it that let this be election be done by the society. That means now don't go anywhere, come to the society, fine. But there are certain issues, certain societies where there is a dispute, where there are issues, there are things. Why not? If that are the issues, in order to address those issues, why you are putting everybody into trouble? Let that society in the general body decide that, okay, in our society we want to have an election. Then let them go to this process and get the things addressed through the authority, wherever there is a dispute. If there is no dispute, let it be addressed by the society level. This is what exactly you are trying to communicate. We have one suggestion, that let there be a dynamic. Third, now if we look at the Constitution of India, where a separate chapter has been included for the cooperatives, and the Constitution of India is very clear under the 97th Constitutional Amendment, in order to have a free and fair election, there has to be separate state-wise cooperative election authority, under whose supervision and monitoring this entire thing should happen. But if we are talking about a cooperative housing society, is also a cooperative society, which means we cannot dilute or we cannot change the Constitution of India. So the Constitution of India is saying that there has to be free and fair election. It has to be through the state cooperative election authority. So which means there has to be some mechanism wherein we will be able to keep a loop of state cooperative election authority. The best would be, as you rightly pointed out, keep a portal wherein any election that is happening, go on intimating, whether they admit or don't admit, the moment you submit, if there is no reversal, which means it is as good as accepted. What happens in the appointment of the auditor? Let me tell you. In the case of an appointment of auditor, the general body appoints the auditor, we intimate the appointment to the registrar, that's it. And if the registrar is not happy, then only he will keep the hearing, and then he may change the auditor, which in my history of 27 years, nowhere it has happened. So the moment you appoint an auditor, you intimate to the registrar, because there is a panel of auditors, you intimate to the registrar, and then it goes. But as he's rightly pointed out, then there are some people who say that no, this is not done nicely, this audit is not very good. Then the registrar calls for the audit report, he calls the auditor, he calls the society, he calls the agreed person. Then if he gets convinced, then he orders for a re-audit. At whose cost? At the cost of the person who is aggrieved. And once he pays the money, re-audit takes place. And in the re-audit, whatever point that aggrieved person has pointed out is proved rightly, then his fees, whatever he has paid, will be refunded, and then the society will be asked to make the payment, and the fees which has been paid to earlier auditor will be recovered. So this is the process which is done in the audit, to have autonomous, independent body. And this has been suggested in the Constitution of India. So in the case of election, There are divided opinion, but we need to come to a consensus as to what we can. Let us understand fundamentally, every cooperative housing society is a statutory body. It is registered under a statute. That statute is prepared on the basis of the Constitution of India. So considering that, there need to be a regulator. So we have a regulator like registrar. It is with every regulator, whether it is a ROC, whether it is a SEBI, whether it is a IRDA, whether it is any regulator that you talk about, even today RERA we are talking about for real estate. There are issues. But when there is no regulator, the things are not done the way it is required. It is not formalized. There is so many issues. The chaos is created. Everybody, let me tell you how the election used to happen in the society. Let us understand this. Some societies, once in 6 months will conduct election. Somebody says once in a year. Somebody says once in 3 years. Somebody says once in 5 years. Some societies do not take election for years together. And some societies, one person resigns, another person comes in. There was no standardization. When it was seen by the central government, they tried to formalize it through the constitution, and then that has been percolated in the state. Now there are issues. We need to address the issues. So let me put it in three questions and you can raise the hand. Let me take it as a majority and majority concern, and we'll move to the second one. So right now there are two views, as I said. One, giving free hand to the society. The second, we will at least have a 10% control, saying that the election officer has to be from the state cooperative election authorities, based on their qualification, experience, so that the actions can be taken on the election officer if he is doing something wrong. The third, yes, what we are saying is, let us continue with the existing system. What is the existing system? Telling the register, this one, going, so existing system, are you happy with the existing system? No. Answer is no. So just raise the hand, how many of you are saying we are not happy with the existing system? So which means, almost all are not happy with the existing system of the election. So the requirement is to be changed. Now let us come to the second. How many of you are saying that it should be given to the society themselves? The auditors, the panel of auditors, may be treated as the panel of election officers. One. Main kya bol raha hu? Aapko election ka authority chahiye? एम्पैनलमेंट करना चाहिए उसका नया प्रोसीजर करने की जगह में आप ये बता दो जो ऑडिटर्स का पैनल है जहां ऑलरेडी 15,000 ऑडिटर्स है उनको ही हम घोषित करते हैं कि दिस इज इलेक्शन ऑफिसर्स पैनल बट कैन द ऑडिटर बी इलेक्शन ऑफिसर द आंसर इज नो बिकॉज द रीजन इज वंस यू आर एन ऑडिटर यू शुड बी इंडिपेंडेंट पर्सन इफ यू आर ऑल्सो कंडक्टिंग द इलेक्शन देन यू आर giving service to the society in a different way, you cannot have an independence. What it can happen is, suppose you are an auditor of that society, maybe he is also an auditor of another society, but he also understands everything, he can be appointed as an election officer. So your suggestion to that extent can be accepted, but an auditor giving him election duty is not in the good taste, not to the same person. But you got my point? So his view is that let the, if at all the auditors are agreeing or if the government decides, anybody from the auditors panel can be appointed election officer. And in addition to that, if there are some, let us say, retired officer, there are certain advocates who want to become election officers, one more panel can be prepared in addition to the auditors. Because every auditor may not be interested in conducting the election also.